On my team also there, they made a commitment right after, you know, last night. They prepared a sheet of paper, and then they put their name, and they signed, and they want us to also to, you know, to be the witness that in Whistler event, they are committed to contribute to 25,000 licensed people. They commit 50 licensed people. Sorry guys, I'm so excited here. And you know, because the time, I know it's rolling. And and I'm so excited. You know what? I'm so proud with Team Synergy. This is your time. And I'm so proud of you, Aldrin and Patricia, for leading by example. And I know this is just the beginning for you. This is your day, okay? And I just want to share a little bit. But before that, I just want to thank again Carl. You know what? FYI, Carl doesn't have any vested or financial interest in the team. But look at that. WFG is open to everybody. We can collaborate each other, leadership, input, and everything. And that's the beauty of that, of being here in this company. And I'm so proud, and I want to thank you. We really appreciate that, Carl. And a little bit of my story. You know, we're 19 years in the business. We're both accountant back home, me and my husband. He's my backbone, my mentor. And without you know, doing this as a couple, we're one of the big, strong couple power in the company. And we started from nothing. Also, you know, we started in a small office, which I believe some of you have to connect to plug in, but we fight for the compliance that we have to start in our basement, flooded, water, and you know what? We save money, they approve us that one in 1 year, and then after that they forgot that they only give us a 1 year a temporary approval for the compliance, because physical, they really want to make sure that the office is presentable. But you know what? I saved money. Me and my husband, 10 years after, we were able to purchase 5,000 square feet office in Hamilton. And I think that was a pretty normal story. We're drawn in debts, and less than a year, we're able to pay the 82,000. And you know what? Everything is just coming. We just work every day. I just want to make sure that every day I have 3 appointments. I never stop. I never stop calling people. And I think this is the difference between other people, that they weren't able to make it because of their mindset, right? I love what Carl mentioned about mindset. And I think these are the people that, you know, I just want to share you the Elmo is. Okay, this is what we have seen when we started, me and Gary. 1998, someone introduced this business to us, this opportunity, and we're very skeptical. We thought it's the same MLM before, because we've been in that kind of life before. We tried vacuum cleaner, we tried a lot of herbal product. We thought it's going to help us to add additional income for our family because of that 82,000 debts that we had. But you know what? I've seen the real problem. And these are the things that people, they cannot move on. People, they cannot reach their goal. The challenge of your mind. Can you? Okay. The challenge of your mind. Guys, I don't have enough time for you to read everything. But guys, look at this. This is the problem that, you know, our mind before. And you just have to know, think positive, embrace a change, and apply the leverage concept of creating wealth. Isn't it? These are the things that a lot of people having a problem. That's why they cannot move on. And my question for you is that, what successful people separate us from unsuccessful people? Isn't it the mindset? Right? And I love the word Carl mentioned, mindset. This is very important. No matter what's your skills, no matter what's your knowledge, no matter how good you are. Me, I'm not very good in public speaking. But the only thing that separates me from other people is that my mindset. I really have to work every day. I really have to make sure that I have something that I can deliver. I was asked to speak in Las Vegas Convention. That was, I'm just starting in the basement. Because you know what? Numbers can't lie. If they saw you in your performance, the company will look for you. we gotta see who is this Nelia Destacamento. And then when they asked me that, you gotta speak, you know what? First of course, right? You feel nervous, right? And I'm thinking, I told my husband, you have to help me. And I know Carl was there. He was the one who, you know, shake my hands, and he said, you did a great job, you delivered. And you know what? I love this story of other people. And this is where me and my husband was trying to put it. The story of other people. The thing that I was challenged, they can do it, I can do it.
Yes.
And you know what? Once we become, you this one. Once your mind become positive, this is the only thing that we focus in, me and my husband and the rest of our team. But three ways not to worry about money. Isn't it a lot of people are worrying about money? And the reason why some of us here, especially the immigrants, we have a dream in our life that coming here, we're thinking we can give a better future for our family. But what happened? The profession that we are looking for, we're not able to make it. And we ended up working, in hard work, labor environment. I got carpal tunnel. I was, when Vicky Omega shared her story, I can relate that we have the same story. One night, my husband, asked me in the 911 because I cannot move my shoulder because of that hard work. The machine that we have to really, follow, or else we're gonna find you. But look at that. Someone put our name in the prospect list. And me and my husband is telling, how can we win our life back here in Canada? We have a good life in the Philippines, but we never know that coming here, there's 82,000 deaths waiting for us. So it's good. God is so good. We're so great. God give us the opportunity that, as I said, someone put our name in that place. So, you know what? It's a history after that. And these are the three ways that, what's the traditional approach that people are doing right now to save money for their retirement? This is, they have to save money, they put it in the bank, start disciplining themselves to save money. The second one is the cuts, okay? Traditionally, people are, buying house, flipping that, but is that a good legacy that you can leave to your family? But the third one that really, that you can build a passive income here, building people. And that's what, we focus on, me and my husband. Without any capital, it's just your mindset, it's just your focus. And look, what is our, and what will happen after we focus on building people? Now, I want to ask you this question. Is it worth it to put your time and build your financial future? If you were able to, build a team like this, I still have 1 minute. Last year, before I turned my 60, golden, that's what my team, in one of my team in Ontario said, Lilia, most of my recruit right now are all golden girls. And I said, what do you mean? Because most of them are 60 and above. And I told myself, oh my God, I'm so lucky. At least before I become a golden 60. Girls, I was able to hit my
1 million. Golden girl.
And this is the team that, with pandemic, we still, when I try to calculate our cash flow, guys, when we hit our 1 million last year, some people, they run for promotion, they run for cash flow, they want to be recognized. But for us, it never goes down to 1 million. It's going up and going up. So, guys, I'm so excited. What you have to do is that focus on what you're doing. Last thing that you can, I'll tell it to you, is that if you have, we only have 386 licensed people right now. Now, if you can double this number, what will you be your future? So you all of you here can answer that. So if you stay longer, you know. In closing, we are a team of few words, but more in action. Thank you guys.